It is take two of July 4th here in Portland and in many other cities and towns. Good evening and thanks for joining us tonight. I'm Tracy Sable. Last night's torrential rain and lightning postponed fireworks displays and forced thousands to run for cover. The skies have cleared and people are giving the 4th of July festivities, well, another shot. News 8's Meghan Torjussen is live on Portland's Eastern Prom with more. Meghan?
Yeah, Tracy, I wish I had one of those director's clapboard things where we could go like this and say, like, take two on the 4th of July. But for some of these vendors, though, that's not such a bad thing. They consider this a bonus day. Make a little money yesterday, make a little money today, and it's plus it's a great place to have dinner. Check this out. Hot dogs, $2. And speaking of dinner and a show, some of these folks are beginning to filter in to try and see this show. You know, it's a work day today, so it might be a little slow going. Anyway, they're staking their spot to see tonight's show. Of course, last night's show, courtesy of Mother Nature.
And it was like a river. It washed. The carts domino flipped over, and we literally had to scatter about grabbing all the stuff.
An inventory nightmare is how concession stand owner Mike Woodbury described last night's storm.
That was one of the most unique storms that I've seen in a long time. I've been doing this for a few years, but that was pretty unique.
A storm that forced the city to postpone the Stars and Stripes Spectacular. For the Hopkins family, this is as close as they got to fireworks.
Boom, 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 boom.
If all went according to plan, we were going to come. But we expected there would be obstacles. We didn't realize it was going to be an electrical storm.
The lightning and rain created a show of another kind.
From our house on North Street, we saw lots of people running back in the rain with their folded lawn chairs and coolers.
Lightning and pounding rain sent spectators running for cover. It was a storm city officials hoped would pass, but it quickly got worse, forcing the decision to postpone.
We do purchase weather insurance, which means that that would help offset the cost or defray the cost of repeating the concert today.
In all, the event costs $150,000, much of which is a one-time cost. The Portland Symphony Orchestra, however, will need to be paid for both last night and tonight. The city says the insurance will cover $30,000 of that, but if the event sponsors can't cover the added cost, it could be passed on to the taxpayer. Beyond today, Clegg says, there is no contingency plan.
We're coming out.
Okay. Second time's a charm?
Second time's a charm.
It should be.
Hopefully not a third.
Yep, there will be no third. Now, tonight, there are a few differences, and they all have to do with the transportation variety. Munjoy Hill was left open a little later to accommodate the folks who are coming home from work. There is no bike valet service, and the bus will not be coming up this way until 7 o'clock, before 7 o'clock. The bus will be left down at the bottom of the hill. And, of course, the fireworks, they begin, fingers crossed, 9:20 this evening. Live in Portland, Meghan Torjussen, News 8.